This is the first ever English session, English track in PyCon Taiwan. And we are very happy we have a lot of audience here. So our first speaker is Takayuki Shimizukawa from Japan. He is a very active Python developer, and he's going to bring us a talk about the Sphinx document generator. So let's give him a very welcome.
Introduction to Sphinx Documentation Generator. Hi everyone. Today I'll talk about Sphinx Documentation Generator. Thank you for the opportunity for this presentation. Before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Takayuki Shimizukawa. I came from Japan. I joined the PyCon Taiwan last year, and it is my second time to come to Taiwan. My activity is in Sphinx. I'm a Sphinx core maintainer and Sphinx users JP chairman. And Python, I was a vice chairman PyCon JP in last 2 years. And books, expert Python programming translation into Japanese, and Python proficient programming two chapters. This both is in Japanese books, and the books mentioned to Sphinx and documentations. And by the way, Python professional programming was already translated into simple Chinese characters and will publish in June, I heard. And this is Chinese version of book name. Anyway, the Sphinx. Today's slide is already published, and I tweeted my Twitter and with hashtag PyCon Taiwan and other hashtag. This link is worked. We already worked, and you can use your device the same slides. And the Sphinx. Today I'll talk about documentation generator. This is called Sphinx. And I will talk about Sphinx by three parts: introduction, demonstration, and case studies. First, I will introduce what is Sphinx and what is restructured text. By the way, how many people already using Sphinx? Okay, please raise your hands. Already use Sphinx? Oh, very small members. Thank you. And do you know Sphinx? Oh, many people already know. Thank you. And okay, what is Sphinx? Sphinx is a documentation generator. Sphinx generates documentation from extract text markup. And in other words, Sphinx read REST text file and output HTML, EPUB, PDF, or other several formats. Sphinx is extendable, so you can also output in a different format or read the file in a different format. And normally, Sphinx read REST file only, but you can extend if you write extension. And normally, write output many formats. And if extension exists, you can output other formats. And restructured text. Restructured text is a markup language. It was written with plain text. And REST is similar to other wiki-like markup, but different from others. The REST syntax is extendable too. It's an important point. This is a markup sample that contains link and emphasis and strong and Sphinx restructured role syntax. This will render with this output. Okay. Sigis provides many useful REST syntaxes and code blocks, code for code highlighting directives, and many directive and roles. At later, I will demonstration this. And Sphinx includes simple and beautiful HTML themes that name the default Sphinx doc and scroll, agogo, traditional, nature, hike, and pyramid. Pyramid theme, I had contributed by pyramid project. And there's a third-party themes. You can find third-party syntax Sphinx themes at PyPI or other sites. For example, BizStyle and dotted and basic strap with Twitter strap CSS and Sphinx JP themes. And other, and a few presentation themes also exist. S6 and HTML slide and Impress.js. And this slide also to use S6 theme. This slide written by Sphinx. And what is not Sphinx? Sphinx did not, so also introduce Sphinx is not possible. Are there GUI front-end editor? No. Sphinx did not have GUI front-end as like as Word. But you can choose any GUI editor to edit REST plain text, like Windows Notepad or Mac editors. And there's a way to import or export Word? No. Sphinx did not have a way to import Word file. However, there is an experimental implementation to build Word docx file, but it is not stable. Next, there is a way to export a PowerPoint. No. Sorry, this slide we built by Sphinx, but this slide controlled by HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. These elements and not easy to convert PowerPoint file. And there are a way to export Excel. What I say? In Japan, many documentation have been made with Excel. It is not feasible. I think because it is not easy to maintenance and not easy to recognize the difference by changing. I think Sphinx will never support to combat Excel. Conclusion, Sphinx is a documentation generator and read REST and write several file formats, extends REST syntax and provide many useful roles and directives. Contain many beautiful HTML themes, extenders, not include Office File Converter. Next, Sphinx extensions. Sphinx have many extensions, like Autodoc, Autodocumenter for Python module, Mass Renderer, and Link Other Document Over Internet, InterSphinx, GraphViz support, To-Do, DocTest, Coverage. Some elements I will demonstration later. And many third-party extensions. BlockDiagram is rendering some type of diagram from plain text like GraphViz. And domains, language signature rendering supports, or else. And you can find the extension in a PyPI, for example, HTML themes and textile or docx builders. Docx, but docx is not stable. Next, comparison with other documentation tool. word like Office app and Wiki comparing. Things versus Office. Things have many files and directories to build a document. And the Office file is one monolithic file. Things format is plain text, and Office is binary. And things need learning to write at beginning. But Office is easy to use. Things is restructuring is very easy. And Office file is restructuring, I think it is difficult. And versioning is, things is plain text, then versioning is too easy with HG or Git or else. Office have a versioning function have by self having. Things match to work with program source. And the Office match to others, I think. Things versus Wiki. Things and Wiki or other syntax, text markup syntax is very similar. But Things structure is one tree. Things all files joined one tree. And but Wiki structure is not tree structures. It's a semi-lattice structure. Then Sphinx root and Sphinx is one root and one path from start to end. But Wiki have no root and no order to read. Cross-via reference and glossary and index is also exist. Sphinx match to books, order to read is important. Wiki match to dictionary. I think so too. Next, demonstration. Things installation is easy. Easy install is Python de facto standard installer. And Things 1.2 beta 1 is the current newest version. This command installs Things and other dependency packages. This computer already installed Things. Then I did not demonstration. I could not. And Things quick start. Things quick start command also installed. And Things quick start same command to make some scaffold files. Sorry. Things quick start and foo. Create a foo directory and some questions and you need answer. But almost questions is default. Project name is foo and author foo. Version 1.0. And other question is all default I answered. This create a foo directory and some subdirectory and files. And you can make HTML, generate HTML output in build HTML directory. This is first index HTML output. Okay. I'll demonstrate these menus, but this menu is too long, and I skip some demonstrations. First, bullet list. This is a simple bullet list. This restructured text renders as this. This is a HTML output. But tip is you need blank line before and after nested items. And the nested item need two spaces before semicolon, asterisk. Oh, sorry. These spaces. Oh, sorry. Next, numbered list is simple too. Sharp dot, this syntax is render auto numbered list, but it is not human readable. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2. But this source code is not human readable. Restructure text designed for human readable syntax. Then I always write a number dot point instead of sharp dot sharp dot. And the code highlighting. This is a Ruby code, but highlighting is work well. Code block directive. You can provide other format about REST, Python, Python or C++ or else. Things depend on docutils library. Docutils also support code directive. Code directive is provide a similar feature. And link to other pages. This is a toctree, already I said. Toctree directive connection to other pages with one structure from root to leaves. Then this rendered as like this. This is a spam.rest file and egg.rest file exist in this project, same directory with this presentation slide. And spam.rest file have, this is a spam page title, this title. Then Sphinx render, compile and rendering spam.rest file's title in this. This is a table of contents features. And link to other page. And Sphinx also provides a glossary directive. And glossary directive have a keyword and description, the list. This rendered as this. And it is, it can be, these glossary terms are linked from other pages by using term role like this. This work is, this renders with this keyword. And, I skipped this. And the numerical formula. These mass role and mass directive render as these numerical formula output. This feature work with PNG file or JavaScript or work with LaTeX output. To do extension, I skip this. And Autodoc extension. Autodoc is generate from Python file. There is a Python.py file and REST file write this sentence. And this render as this output. PersonPy. This is a PersonPy file, and Sphinx pass this code and document, and render into Sphinx as like as this, and link over internet. Domains is a domain is a collection of markup to describe and link to object belong together. This code py function directive define event register description, signature and description. And you can use colon_py, colon_func and event register name. And this render as this. This is a API references feature. And I skip this. Sorry. And blockdiag extensions. Blockdiag is a third-party extension for Sphinx. You can install these commands. And you need these sentences in a conf_py. And you can use blockdiag diagram. And this is similar to GraphViz syntax, but blockdiag rendering a very squared diagram. And blockdiag series provides other diagram format. Secdiag extension render from this code to this diagram, sequence diagram. And next, case studies. Sphinx official reference is the first case study. Sphinx official reference is created by using Sphinx. For instance, Sphinx API path for developer is describe reference of function and classes that was generated by Autodoc. This source code render as this HTML. And Sphinx Japanese reference also exists. Japanese reference, Japanese translated reference page is in the Sphinx user JP was generated by Sphinx with Japanese translation catalog that was imported from Transfix service. Transfix will help you to translate in a team. And Sphinx INTL Intel also support your works. And blog. Sphinx is a documentation generator, but many users use as blogging or site or a public site, public pages. And there is a blog support tool. Tkinter provides original. Tkinter is a blog tool made by using the Sphinx. You can be written your blog in restructured text format. In addition, you can use the rich Sphinx extension too. Tkinter provides an original command to manage your blog. Create a new blog and create blog entries, tkinter-p. And build HTML, tinkerer-b is a build HTML and RSS file. Okay, and that's all. Any questions?
I'll ask one in the back. Can you hear me okay? Do you know if anybody has tried to do anything with Sphinx and IPython notebook? Do you know about the IPython notebook, Brian? Specifically, like being able to take maybe like generate an IPython notebook from a restructured text document.
This? Sorry, I did not try it yet.
I guess my question is, do you know whether anybody's tried to use Sphinx to generate IPython notebooks at all? Mm-hmm. I have this idea of like it'd be kind of interesting to be able to produce an IPython notebook from documentation.
Sorry.
An open-ended question, so I don't know. So.
This is a very interesting idea to combine IPython notebook with the Sphinx. Yeah. So maybe we can talk to the community later. Okay. So any question? Any more questions? Okay. Yeah. I think this is a very interesting introduction to this.
Excuse me. Okay. And I have extra information. Sorry. I'd like to introduce PyCon APAC in this autumn and the Sphinx Users Committee in Japan. We will hold a 3-day Python event at September 14th, 15th, 16th in Tokyo, Japan. Registration of this event will start middle of June. And Sphinx Users JP and Sphinx Users Committee group in Japan that was called Sphinx User JP. The group managed original site that contained full translate reference, original tutorial, and reverse dictionary for Sphinx. Also, we hold monthly event Sphinx and Translation Hackathon and annual event named SphinxCon JP. SphinxCon JP last year was very exciting. I think the first Sphinx event in the world, maybe. About 70 people were gathered on this event. We would like to do something in PyCon APAC on this year, too. Please join to PyCon APAC. And one more. I brought two Sphinx t-shirts. This and but I have only two sizes, S or XXL. Sorry. Do you want this t-shirt? Anyone? S or XXL? Oh, one. Okay. Okay, and
give a big thanks to Mr. Takayuki.